European unification is a question of when, not if. Whether sudden through the collapse of the North or gradual through increased contact between the two sides, unification will be a challenge. However, it'll also present an opportunity to generate growth and peace in Asia. Regardless of the speed of unification, there are medium to longer term issues to tackle in knitting the two societies together. A first-of-its-kind groundbreaking study looked at past examples of unification-related and state-building tasks in several countries. The lessons learned unveiled five key lessons for Korean unification. 1. Internal migration will be more chaotic than external migration. Conventional wisdom is that refugees will flood across Yalu and Tumen rivers to China, and others will seek to move south. However, migration experts find that people generally don't want to leave their homes, especially if they have food and feel that they're secure. Those who know someone who successfully migrated are likely to move, but since most North Koreans don't know anyone who did, high migration outflow isn't guaranteed. The bigger problem will be internally displaced persons as people try to come to the city or look for family members. This will stress already vulnerable food and security systems, which means having plans to provide food and security quickly in the North post-unification will be critical. 2. Reestablishing a health infrastructure will be challenging. Despite a state health system, North Korea struggles with significant disease problems, including measles, TB, smallpox, and cholera, among others. The average height of a 7.5-year-old North Korean boy is approximately 3 inches shorter as compared with his South Korean counterpart. The average weight of a 7.5-year-old North Korean boy is approximately 7.3 kilograms less than his South Korean counterpart. Experts from efforts in other regions stressed restoring the health infrastructure is a top priority for unification to limit disease and to gain the trust of the North Korean people. However, solutions cannot be imposed from outside. They must be tailored to the situation at hand, and doctors have to work with whatever coping mechanisms North Koreans have developed. Currently, NGOs have been successful locally in North Korea, but they will need help scaling up to a national level. 3. Transitional justice must be viewed as reconciliation, not revenge. The common view is that all of the North Korean bad guys in the party, military, and intelligence circles should be prosecuted and thrown in jail. However, countries such as South Africa and Mali show that this is not the ideal solution. Justice that seeks high-profile acts of vengeance will not create reconciliation. It will create an us versus them attitude and breed fear. Yes, some will go to jail, but others should be offered alternatives. For example, the nuclear director should be prosecuted to the fullest extent, but perhaps amnesty could be given to scientists in order to learn important details about the clandestine nuclear program. 4. Economic opportunity could exist under the shambles. Most think the North Korean economy is in shambles and that unification will be too expensive. It is true that the average South Korean is about 25 times richer than the average North Korean. In comparison, at the time of unification, West Germans were about twice as rich as East Germans. To this day, Germany is still working to achieve economic equality. However, the economic situation may not be that dire, and potential does exist in North Korea. It has significant natural resources and relatively high social capital, including education, literacy, and urbanization. In a unified Korea, the North's literate labor force could be married up with the South's capital and management. We have seen pockets of such potential in Kaesong. The greatest underestimated resource is the entrepreneurial potential of the North Korean people, which is very high as evidenced in the growth of formal and informal markets. 5. Unification as a driver of regional peace and cooperation. Unification needs to be led by Koreans with support from the United States as well as other regional powers. The spectrum of support might range from strong, U.S., to reluctant, China. However, U.S., Chinese, Japanese, and Russian experts in the project all agreed that the process of unification needs to end not in a system of 19th century balance of power politics, but in a 21st century security community. Laying the groundwork of support now will ensure that unification will be a driver of peace and cooperation for the region. The potential of unification to bring North Korea fully into Northeast Asia promises short-term costs, but unification can also offer an enormous upside that can benefit the entire region.